Hi, and welcome to another episode of Wine by Night. Tonight, we're going to be discussing Sauvignon Blanc. And in terms of that, it is like other grape varieties, and it can be known in certain styles and regions where it's grown. There's a few different core regions that grow Sauvignon Blanc. France in the Loire Valley has like a little elegant, crisp style of wine that they make. You can move into Sancerre and then over into Pouilly-le-Fume. And those ones are in a little bit more unique style when they're made. And then you can hop over to New Zealand, which is what most people do think of when they're thinking and talking and discussing Sauvignon Blanc. And it's one of those wines that's really nice and comfortable to have on a wine list at a restaurant because it does go with a lot of different foods. And it's familiarity that your customer's going to see and know. And they can be like, oh, a New Zealand Sauvignon Blanc should be really herbaceous and gooseberry and, you know, crisp and citrus and dry. And they're comfortable with that. So their experience is already better. However, from maybe watching some of my videos, I'm not necessarily that person. I like to kind of push the envelope a little bit. So tonight we are going to talk about a New Zealand Sauvignon Blanc. But one of the things I wanted to touch base on in terms of like kind of the geeky side is that those aromas that you're smelling and accustomed to, those are like your pyrazines and your thiols. And it's like your sugar and acid content in grapes. As the grape is ripening, those pyrazines are starting to decrease. And once they hang out on the vine and they're getting ripe, that's when those thiols can start accumulating and build up. Now, depending on the winemaker, and I've always referred to them as magicians and their voodoo magic, that they can make a grape taste however they want in the style that they want. It is true also in this, and those are kind of the things that they look at and they play with, and they taste their grapes because they want to know, like, where am I at on here, and where am I at on the thiols, pyrazine, and thiol contents. So those pyrazines, that's what you're going to be looking at when people are talking about your green pepper notes and your asparagus and all of those things. And how I break it down according to thiols is kind of more like the fruit and the floral notes. So I look at it is, if you have black currant leaf and you have black currants, the currant leaf, those are giving you those pyrazine notes, and the berry, that's giving you those thiols. So that's kind of like my simplification of, absolutely there's going to be exceptions to it, but that's how I sort of think about it in my mind when I'm like looking at things. So tonight we are actually going to be talking about a New Zealand Sauvignon Blanc, and I was excited to pick up the one I did for a few different reasons, but in our market here in New Brunswick, most Sauvignon Blanc or most wines from New Zealand range $20 and up. And although I like New Zealand Sauvignon Blanc and it's interesting and I can expect it to be what I think it should be when I open it, sometimes I won't spend that extra $5 to get that next one, because is it really gonna taste different? Is it gonna give me something more unique that I'm looking for? Or am I gonna be still just as happy as if I'd spent the $20, $22 for it? But in this case, it was the label that caught my interest. And this is from Marlborough region, and it is called the Squealing Pig. Now, I don't know if you folks are all at home with children. I am home with children. You may hear them in the background. And so this struck me funny because it's got this pig, it's got this new age label on it, and it actually gives you the nursery rhyme of this little pig went to market, except it says this little pig went to Marlborough, this little pig stayed home, this little pig, and it says had roast beef, and they've scratched it out and said cool fermentation, and then this little pig had none, and they wrote down minimal handling, this little pig went wee wee wee. And one, maybe it was the mood I was in when I picked it up, struck me as funny. I laughed out loud. And then I also thought it was really poignant because it says wee, wee, wee. And a lot of times folks will say, I don't want a wine that smells like cat pee or asparagus. And sometimes in the wine world, other people look at us and you're like, oh, you're snobby, you're using these terms. And when you use asparagus and green pepper and boxwood and things, but other people interpret that as cat pee. And you're like, oh, I don't want my wine to taste like that either or smell like that. But when it's done right and it's in balance, they're good things. So that's what's exciting about this wine. And I went ahead and poured some in my glass. And also, I had a couple wins this spring because I've tried several times to grow and procure lemongrass, and I've not been able to do that. It's not something that's always readily available, or it's just never there when I try to get it. So I do have a little prop sitting right here behind me, this plant right here, and I've been playing with its leaves this week because this is a lemongrass plant. And I broke off a piece of it and I swished it up as you would like a herb or anything like that, and was really smelling it. And I was like, oh, that's what smells like lemongrass. And so until you smell it, it's really one of those interesting things because I've not smelled a gooseberry. So for me to describe a New Zealand wine, yes, from all the books and everything that someone's telling me, there should be gooseberry in there. But it's not something that's readily available that I can be like, oh, that's gooseberry. I can assume it is, but I don't know. So typically in my notes on Sauvignon Blanc, I'll describe like the citruses and some florals maybe if they're there, the green fruits, the melons. Sometimes you can get a riper area of like that. But this one is perfect as an example. New Zealand Sauvignon Blanc. We'll talk about the color. It's this light pale lemon with these green flecks to it. It's quite gorgeous. And then on the nose, it's really aromatic, which you expect from a New Zealand Sauvignon Blanc. They have that cooler climate, but they've got all these really long days of sunlight. So it stretches the growing season out, and you get to have those thiols and those pyrazines like develop and really stay there. So this one, it jumps out with me with the lemon, the lime, the grass. Hi, so we had a little tech glitch earlier. I think I've worked through it. However, I am still talking about New Zealand Sauvignon Blanc, and I have gone ahead and poured some in my glass here, as I think that's where I got cut off. You can tell from the color here, it's a really nice pale straw and it's got kind of those green glints to it. It's really quite pretty. On the nose, it is what I'm expecting. It is jumping out of the glass at me. It's very aromatic, but it's got a little bit more nuances to it. You get that lemongrass smell from prepping on my lemongrass plant that's behind me that I moved back upstairs to. You get those great citrus notes, those lime, the lime peel, the lime juice, like all of the lime. There's some herbiness to it, like an herbal, possibly green pepper, but at the same time, there's like this minerality in this wine that you kind of get, but it's not smoky, but it's there. So that's interesting. Let's give it a try. Wow. So what you're expecting in a New Zealand Sauvignon Blanc is that really mouth-watering acidity, that crispness, and that little kind of tanginess to it as well. This one definitely has a medium plus high acidity to it, possibly even a little bit more. This one has warmed up just a little bit, but it's still zingy. It's like it's tangy. There's no effervescent in this one. There's no petulance when you're pouring, or that was a visual, but you kind of feel that in your mouth where the acidity is so sharp and zingy. It's like ting, ting, ting within your mouth. And at the same time, you get those lemon and the citrus notes. You get a little bit of green notes to it. You're definitely getting lemongrass, maybe some green pineapple in there too. But with that lemongrass, because I did eat a piece of the lemongrass, it's interesting because although I was smelling something mineral on the nose, I don't necessarily get that on the palate, but I get a little titch of spiciness, which I kind of put on to that green vegetal. I don't know if I'd say yet if it was a green jalapeno, but the lemongrass itself does have a little bit of spiciness to it, almost like that kefir lime does as well, if you were going to make like a cocktail sauce with it. So those things I find are really interesting. One thing I would point out is that in particular, this wine, it's leading towards the medium bodied. Now, I do know from looking up this winery, they take, after they've pressed the grapes and they take out they separate it from the lees. Sorry, that's what I'm trying to say. But then they let it sit for a bit with some more, and that kind of gives it these nuances, a little bit of fullness. It can also beef up those aromas as well because each strain of yeast is chosen for its particular characteristics. So that's of interest as well. But overall, this wine is really well balanced. The juiciness of it, the explosion of flavors that you're experiencing, even if you can't pick them out, you can. One of those New Zealand typicity things is that those limes, those citrus, yes, they can go more into the melon, the tropical things, but with this one, you're definitely getting like overall lime, those bright, crisp, ripe citrus notes. For me now, definitely lemongrass, you're getting that herbaceous note, plus a little bit more of that kind of like a little spice at the end just to round it off. And it's not a thin wine, it's not a light-bodied wine, it's leaning towards the medium side. So all of that combined really does balance. So again, the wine we were looking at tonight is from Squealing Pig in the Marlborough area. And this one, I think it was definitely worth the $24.99 that I paid for it in New Brunswick. I would buy it again. So I hope that you like these style of videos, and if you do, please hit the subscribe button. This one, of course, is going to be a conjoined of two different areas. I apologize for that. I'll make it as smooth as I can, as in, I'll get Tristan to do it. Because I'm still learning on that part. So thank you, and if you do like it, feel free to drop a comment, give a thumbs up sign, hit the subscribe button so you know when I post another video. Sometimes I don't always like throw it out there and I just kind of do it at whim, but typically they're every Friday and every Sunday. So I hope you enjoyed it. Again, please share and thanks so much for tuning in. Oh. Cheers, y'all. Thanks a lot.